So I play a character called Detective Chief Superintendent Roland Bell, who's in charge of Renko and Hicks. He has a bit of history with Hicks. They don't really get on particularly well. And before the first episode starts, Hicks's partner, DCI Butler, has died under kind of suspicious circumstances. And he is suspicious that Hicks might be involved in this. And so part of his job in this is to bring Hicks to justice. So he's kind of, Hicks is this sort of renegade cop. And my character is this hard-nosed, seen-it-all Glaswegian detective chief superintendent who's also under pressure from people higher than him as well to bring Hicks to justice, but also the pressure of what's been released with the Hard Sun information and keeping the public trying to keep the public unaware of that and hiding stuff because the government's onto them as well. They're just, their relationship in this, they really carry this show. It's their, you know, you've got to be invested in Renko and Hicks in this it's about their characters more than anything else. I'm in it, but it's about them. And I think they have a really great relationship in it. And it's this fact about who knows what at the right time, who's spying on who, what information they have, and that's always being played out between the two of them through the episodes. They find out more about each other that they didn't know, and then that affects the way in which they behave to each other. And I think by the end, probably, I'm trying to remember, they, you know, come together a bit more, whereas at first they're maybe a bit of loggerheads and suspicious of each other. They come together by the end to try and defeat everything that's going on.
I think what's unique about a Neil Cross script?
I think it's he's not scared to go into sort of weird and dark territory, and I think this, particularly in the later episodes, it goes, takes you to places that you don't expect, and it's quite gruesome and it's quite dark. They were going for sort of feel of a graphic novel in this, I think, when we were filming it. And so, whereas people will know his work from Luther, which again was dark and weird, but this is a slightly, I would say that's more naturalistic, and this is more, like I say, a graphic novel idea with look and script. You have to ask yourself, what would you do if time was running out? What would you do if you know you only had 5 years left? Would you still stick to all the norms, all the laws, or would you just go, oh, forget it, we're all going to go, so I might as well enjoy myself and misbehave? But I don't know if I can make it last for 5 years of misbehaving. But I think that's why, because I think the rules have all changed and people would not probably act. I think that's what this show does. It shows you people acting in ways that they wouldn't normally do. I think I would probably grab my children and start travelling the world and let them see places that they'd heard about and hadn't seen, and just enjoy my time with my family if I knew that was a limited amount of time. I think that's definitely what I would do.